This is the Volvo V60 Cross Country B5 all-wheel drive. Those are all of the words. It's a nasty rainy day, but this is all-wheel drive. It has all-season tires, which isn't the best. This has 248 horsepower, 258 pound-feet of torque from its 2-liter turbo, 8-speed auto, mild hybrid system, but it does weigh 4,100 pounds. It has good speed, but not great speed. 0 to 60, about 7 seconds here. Certainly enough for what most people would ever want to do. Double wishbone front suspension, which means the turn in is nice and exact. Less ride height than an SUV, though it doesn't feel much smaller than an SUV. It feels about the same. It feels almost as tall. Seats are excellent. Heated, cooled. Excellent stereo, good Apple CarPlay. You can go wired or wireless. This car as spec'd, which has some technology packages, some luxury packages as well, is almost $64,000. Start of this car is about $53,000. The 48-volt mild hybrid system just assists you with some torque fill. It isn't really something to think of as an electric car, even though Volvo is making a big point of the fact that all the cars they now sell in the US have some sort of electrification. Now, that could be full electric, but it also could just mean like this, which is a mild hybrid system that helps you out. What a lovely day. Even with just all seasons right here at the freezing point, this car feels very confidence-inspiring. I don't feel concerned about its ability to do what I needed to do or to keep its grip. Obviously, if it was serious winter conditions, I would rather have winter tires on. But this all-wheel drive system and these tires are working fine. Seats are excellent. Nice big roof. You can shift yourself. Ice fishing looks miserable today. I'm driving faster than everyone else on this road. I'm just driving comfortably, which speaks to the ease of use of the Volvo. not even on ideal tires, and it gobbles up the speed and the miles and the corners just fine. It's not a standout in dynamics, but it'll do anything you want it to do. Certainly a much more interesting family hauler than your typical five-seat SUV. You got to use the shifter, if that matters. In spite of weighing 4,100 pounds, which is a lot, this does have a lot. This does have a wide, low stance. Makes it feel very confidence-inspiring. Double wishbone suspension up front, which makes the steering responsive. There's not any feeling, but it's responsive and precise. The body roll here is definitely less than you would get in your typical five-seat SUV, even though this is the cross-country version, so it's up a little bit over your typical V60. Heads-up display tells me I'm speeding. Similar Volvo interior to everything else they make right now, the same vents, the same interface. All of that stuff is refined well and working well in all of the current Volvo generation. Hello, good sir. slightly downshifting kind of make this happen. I think so. Numbers aren't great in the spec sheet, but the passing power is fine. Can't help you with the Subaru Outback, though. There's just nothing I can do. Sorry, BMW. Snowing? Is it raining? We don't know. Now it's snow. So thank you for watching this Volvo V60 Cross Country B5 all-wheel drive POV. You can subscribe for more. All of the cars we test drive, we also do a POV. And this is also my opportunity to say, please, please, if you live in a wintry environment, get winter tires. This press car showed up on all seasons and it did okay, but we would prefer some Bridgestone Blizzaks or some winter tire of choice on your car.